Hi, my name is Om Sagasong. There are top 10 facts that you should know about abstract class in Java. Even though it is in Java, but you can apply it in your programming language. If you are new, my channel is about Android app development tutorial and Java programming. And I just created a new course series called Design Pattern of Software Engineering. An abstract class will be used a lot in the course. That is why before you can begin, you have to understand the abstract class. But before we begin, I would like to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell next to it, so that in the future, you will not miss any tutorial. Okay, let's go into it. Abstract class is one of the most useful features in OOP, yet abstract class is a difficult subject to understand for most OOP beginners. Abstract class is a bit mysterious its own way. It has been employed every time in design patterns. The first reason to use abstract class is polymorphism. I will make another video to explain why you should use abstract class and why you should use polymorphism and how to do it. So what are the top 10 facts you should know about abstract class in Java? Okay, let's dive into it. Number 10. Abstract class must declare with abstract modifier. Unlike a user class or a concrete class that you can begin with a class keyword with one of four modifiers, public, protected, private, or blank for default, abstract class must declare with abstract modifier. Even though it is obvious for learners, but it is also important to stress out first. Number 9. Abstract class cannot create instance. One of the most irritated things about abstract class, which seems also like to break the OOP rule, that you cannot create instance from a class. In fact, abstract class is the way to prevent you from creating the instance. There is a good reason why and when you don't want to let anyone to create an object from a class. We will learn more about it, but what I can tell you now is that in OOP, create an instance is not the only way. You can inherit from a parent too. Abstract class is for inheritance. That goes to the next point. Number 8. Abstract class can be called by inheritance. Even though you cannot create an instance from an abstract class, it doesn't mean it is the end of it. You still can get any non-private methods and properties from your parent class by inheritance. Number 7. Abstract class can be a type class. Remember that I told you about polymorphism? How polymorphism works then? I will dedicate a video about polymorphism in Java, but now I can tell you this. Polymorphism will let you declare an instance to be a parent class type, and then you can point to the child class. So abstract class will always be your parent class type. Imagine a strategy game that in your game you can create many soldiers. But there are three types of soldiers like Marine, Airborne, and Commando. They have common skills, but different types of soldier have different types of skills too. It is a good idea to create the soldier class as the abstract parent class, and the others are the concrete child classes. Now you can declare an instance named John Wake, for example, with a soldier class type, but he is a Marine. Number 6. Abstract class can have both abstract methods and concrete methods. As in our earlier example about the soldiers, some skills are common like shooting, jumping, walking, but the other skills like parachuting is just for the airborne soldiers only. That is why concrete class can have both concrete methods for common skills and abstract methods for special skills. Number 5. Abstract methods without body code. Why abstract methods have no body code? This is the most common question students have ever asked, and followed by another question like, if there is no code, how does it work without no code? Well, the answer is, it doesn't work without code. But the intention of abstract class is not direct call from user. You see, people always confuse that after they create a class, they can just use the class. But they can have another layer below the class. In the case of abstract class, it is the first layer, and its subclasses, which are the concrete classes, are the second layer. And finally, the user class is in the third layer. So, in the second layer, the subclasses must implement the abstract method. It means that you will fill the blank. Just like when you create a new account in Gmail, you will fill all your information in. Then in the user class, the third layer, you will be able to call the second layer class to use. See how it works now? Abstract classes is not for direct use. That is why abstract class can have abstract method without body code. There comes to number four. Number four, abstract method must be implemented. I already explained in the previous point that abstract method must be implemented in the second layer class. Number three, abstract class can have constructor. If you go back to number nine, you see the abstract class cannot create an instance. Still, you can have a constructor or more in your abstract class. But why? Again, it is for subclasses. Any of its subclasses must implement the constructors. Likewise, if abstract class does not create any constructor, then its subclasses won't be forced to implement any constructor. Number two, abstract class cannot be final. The main goal of abstract class is for inheritance. From a king to his heir. The final means no more inheritance. So abstract class won't be allowed to be final. Number one, abstract class is not mandatory. Well, it is a release. Abstract class is not always the case for every project. Since Java and most OOP languages except C++ can allow only single inheritance, creating an abstract class to be a superclass is sometimes not a good idea. You can think of interface where you can implement as many interfaces as you want. So if you want a parent class, think about interface first. But if you want to have a parent class that can have both concrete methods and abstract methods, there is no choice but the abstract class. Here are the top 10 facts that you should know about abstract class in Java. So that's it for this video. I hope you like it. If you think this video is useful, please don't forget to hit the like button. Ask me any question in the comment section down below. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you.